told us.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, it's my little puppy today.
It's no use, ma'am. She can't control herself.
She seemed so much better yesterday.
I know, but it's no use. I'll give her the bottle.
No, wait. She's wet. Maybe that's right.
My second child, Gabi, was born at the Mexico City Hospital on September 12th, 1947. She was a beautiful blonde baby with clear blue eyes, completely normal. She weighed 7 pounds. On the third day, while I was recovering, the first symptoms appeared.
This is a severe case of cerebral palsy. Her entire body has been affected, including her vocal cords. It is probable that she is mentally retarded. However, it is possible that she is intelligent but locked inside a body that cannot respond.
The doctors said it was a result of my husband and I having incompatible Rh blood types. Our first child, David, had been born perfectly healthy. After 3 years, no one could tell me if the cerebral lesion had affected Gabi's intelligence or not.
They are not her size, ma'am. That's why they give her the rush. She should be able to control herself at 3.
I need a dry diaper in half an hour, Florencia. There's none left.
Hey, you're new around here, aren't you?
I started last week.
Is it true about that little girl?
Why so many diapers?
They say she doesn't have arms and that her head is backwards. You know, they're Jews. They don't believe in God. Do they treat you well?
Yes.
you to make a decision on this. I'm tired of always being the one who makes decisions.
There is nothing to decide. Gabby is staying here. She has had enough doctors for her lifetime. Switzerland, Houston. There is specialists in Mexico. There will always be a better hospital, another great doctor.
But what if she could learn to talk?
Jerry, when are you going to realize that's a fairy tale?
So what? I prefer the fairy tale.
Jerry, come on, stop it. We have to accept Gabby for what she is.
We don't know what she is.
Then we're going to learn that if we are here and she is off in Baltimore, we have to be honest. Gabby has made our lives so complicated. I cannot even bear to think about her anymore. We don't have a daughter. We have a problem. If we want a daughter, for God's sake, please, let's start treating her like one.
How can we? When she can't communicate with us. Michelle, don't you see that's what it's all about? Like my little sister. I used to take her to see the stones up in the pines by the old village. Look, look, I'd see. Do you see the bird in that tree? And my little sister would look, and the bird would fly away. What color was it? Red, she'd say. And it made me happy to know we saw it in the same way. What do you think, Panchito? Yes, please? Yes,
you think you're doing? What you've done?
What's going on? What are you doing here?
The maid took the girl from her crib while I was asleep.
I just wanted to feed her. You took her out of her bed at 2 o'clock in the morning to feed her?
Shani, what's happening?
Maria, go upstairs. I don't know what your intentions were, but if it happens again, you have to find yourself another job.
Shani, wait. Did she eat all of that food just now? Did she?
I never thought about it. I just became Gabi's nanny. I would spend all day with her, in the morning, at school, in the afternoon, at home, and at night. I slept in her room.
are you doing?
Nothing.
See if you can finish that by next year, Gabby.
We have to finish this, Gabby. The exam is coming.
Hi, Floor. Hi, Mom. Ma, I need the car tonight.
Shari, I would like to have a pleasant dinner.
Why don't you invite her over here?
She was here last week, Mom. Please.
David, you are staying home, and that is final.
Let him go out. I don't care.
That's not the point. I feel that we should all spend at least one night a week together.
Can I live my own life around here? You'd think I was still in grade school or something. I mean, why do I always have to have my friends home? I always have to eat at home, do everything at home. Just so that you can pretend we're a normal family.
David, no one is pretending anything. We are a family, and families spend time together. They talk together. Is this very complicated for you to understand?
You are complicating it, Mom. People get together because they feel like it.
David, don't talk to your mother that way. You're staying, that's it.
Gabby, you've got to get dressed. What's the matter with you? We have to go to school.
What's the matter, Nanny?
I don't know. She won't let me get her dressed. She says she doesn't want to go to school anymore.
It's all right, Gabby. Stay home today. One day or two won't make any difference.
It's not only that. She doesn't want to do anything.
Let her stay home, Nanny.
Excuse me, sir. I wanted to talk to you.
Florencia, what's the matter? Come in. Sit down. Florencia, sit down. So tell me, what's going on? Things are not that simple, my dear Gabriella. You'll always think the rest of the world has it easy because you have it so hard. But that's not really true. Our limitations may be less apparent, but they're just as real. Perhaps even more dangerous because they're less visible. Do you realize Beethoven was deaf? When he composed that music, he heard nothing. How was it possible for him to create such magnificent music? In here. A miracle. But a miracle shared by all human beings. Physically, we look different from the apes. The difference, real difference, is in here. In Beethoven's music. Kafka's writing, fantastic covers of Van Gogh. Everything is possible in here. So you are not handicapped. You have everything that is needed to create in this world. Your foot can write the same words as any philosopher or poet. I refuse to pity you. We invent limitations for ourselves that do not really exist. The difficult thing is to tell the difference between which are real and which are our own fears. I am afraid of trying because I never get anywhere. Do you really think so? Do you want to stay home or away? Is that what you want to do with your life? I won't force you to do anything.
God has a reason for everything. child.
Fall of Maximilian. What happened? Who was involved? And why? Carlos?
What was the question?
Roberto, how about you? Yes.
Teacher, Maximilian was executed by a firing squad by Benito Juarez in Querétaro.
Very good, Gabby.
Very good, Flor. And who told Gabby? With you around, even a wheelchair knows the answers.
Maximilian was executed because he was a parasite. A parasite is someone who lives off others, something useless, like Carlos.
Or understand anything. It just fights what you tell it.
Go back to your
seat. Valentine! Oh,
like,
let me go, you son of a bitch!
Stop it!
What is happening, Gabby? Oh, it's fine. You should see Carlos.
Thank you. I've gone over all the final exams, and I'm happy to say that everyone has passed.
And now what, teacher?
Well, the certificate is so you can continue studying.
Oh, I see. You really think anyone takes this school seriously? Carlos. Carlos. I have a question for you. How many times have you repeated fifth and sixth grades?
None of your goddamned business.
Oh, Carlos isn't happy.
What's the matter with you, huh? You lose your marbles or what?
I'll tell you what. We've graduated twice from sixth grade already. And if we keep it up, we'll be 50 years old and still be here in the sixth grade. And you want to know why? You want to know why? Because you give us these stupid grades out of pity. Yes, they don't mean a damn thing. You know, I overheard how Anita's mom asked you to please graduate her since she'd get depressed if her brother graduated and she didn't.
Fernando, please.
After all, who cares? Because the poor, handicapped little girl will never get anywhere anyway. Right? It's no big deal. Right? Who cares? Right?
Yes, Gabby.
The Greeks threw the... The Greeks threw the handicapped off the Tarpeian Rock to get rid of them.
Now there is a great idea. Excuse me, but I'm getting out of here. I'm getting out of here. Come on, Gabby. Let's get out of this zoo.
Keep your feelings to yourself, or you're gonna get hurt. Gabby, it's late. Let's go to bed.
Dear Fernando, I've been thinking about what you said on the day of the exams. Unless we demand something better, nothing is going to change. It would be easier if there were two of us. What do you think about normal public school? The normals have nothing over us intellectually. We can't let them put our minds into wheelchairs too. I hope to know you better. Your friend, Gabby Brimmer. Mom, I'm just gonna go to the bathroom, okay? That's your letter, Gabby. You're right. But the problem is my parents. Why? Well, you know. They'd think it would be cruel for me to go to a normal school. What do you... What do I think? I want to go, but I just don't think it's going to be easy. Would you prefer to stay in that circus? No.
Fernando's mother is coming.
What's going on here? You're missing the best part of the game. Let's go.
Hello? Hello? Who is this?
Hello, Florencia? Is Gabby there?
Just a moment, Fernando.
Gabby? Are you there? Was that you on the phone just now?
I'm really glad you called. Listen.
I've been thinking about you, and I've got a great idea.
Michelle used to talk about that, too.
Can you imagine them in sleeping bags? No. Men are so childish.
Mom? Mrs. Plummer? Gabby and I have something great we wanted to tell you.
I'd like to propose a toast to our star students.
We have a surprise for you. We are organizing a junior high school at the center so you can continue studying.
But we don't want to go back to that place. You see, Gabby and I have a great idea.
We know that, son. Mrs. Brimmer and I have thought a lot about this, and we're very proud of you and Gabby. It's a wonderful dream. And we agree that you have the right to keep studying.
But we have to be realistic. Public school is impossible.
Gabby, did you tell them anything? Francia?
So, if you want to study...
Wait a minute. Wait, excuse me. I don't know what's going on here. I mean, how did you find out? Mom, you read my letter, didn't you?
That's not important. Everyone agrees that your friendship is something beneficial. We think...
I don't care what you think.
Gabby wants to say something.
Fernando, they wouldn't let you in. And even if they did, it would be too difficult. I mean, just keeping up with the pace of the other children... There's no way.
You don't have the right to do this.
We're supporting you. On Saturday, we're going to have a PTA meeting about the special school.
Gabby says that in studies, they are the same as the normals.
Of course. But there are things you can't do on your own, by yourself.
No, you don't understand a goddamn thing. We don't want special schools. No! We don't want special anything. No! I told you, you don't learn anything there. Everybody passes whether they study or not.
Fernando, could we discuss this calmly?
Calmly? Someone who steals my personal letters. Who the hell do you think you are? Oh, I can't even breathe without you poking into it.
Fernando, where do you think you're going? Fernando.
Fernando, be careful. What?
Are you
all
right?
Somebody please.
Help me, somebody.
The big problem is that your daughter went to a school that is not incorporated in our system.
But there must be a way around that.
My suggestion is she would do better if she continued in a specialized school.
There is no special junior high school.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I wish we could help.
She was the top of her class. Gabby gets bored with special schools because they go very slowly.
But she's not mentally retarded. She has cerebral palsy and that doesn't affect her intelligence. She's the one who sent us here.
Mrs. Brimmer, I'm not deaf. We're sympathetic to your problem, but we have regulations which we can't get around no matter what we do.
In other words, a handicapped person has no right to go to a public school?
To go to public school, your daughter would have to pass an equivalency exam of the entire first 6 years of primary. And that's almost impossible for normal children. Imagine what would happen with your daughter.
I don't know what it is I have today in my soul that turns everything brilliant, makes my mind grow, move, and rise up, not to be crucified. And the mud that was covering it turns into crystal, transparent and marvelous. This was written by my daughter.
If she passes this equivalency exam, she would be accepted. Is that right? Is that right?
If she were to pass, yes. But she won't pass the exam, Mr. Brimmer. You'll get her hopes up just to hurt her. Why waste her and your time?
Because she has the right to try. If she fails like anyone else, but she has the right to try.
You too.
Nanny, what's the matter? What are you doing here? Mommy. What's wrong? Let's go for a walk. Let's go. You can take the exam, so it's up to you now. I mean studying, Gabi.
This morning I woke up with this feeling I didn't know how to deal with, and so I just decided to myself, I'd hide it to myself and never talk about it, and did not go and shout it when you walked into the room.
I think I love you.
I love you.
I think I love you. And my soul afraid of, I'm afraid that I'm not sure. A love there is no cure for. I think I love you. Isn't that what life is made of? Though it worries me to say that I've never felt this way.
We are in trouble.
No, you're not in trouble. We do some work now. Okay. Fernando first. Are you ready, Fernando?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to spin the globe. Ah, Fernando. What is the capital of Hungary?
Budapest.
Gabi? Thailand.
Bangkok. That was such an easy one.
Fernando.
It was.
Fernando. Kenya.
That's a tough one. Why do you give me all the hard ones?
Okay, Gabi.
Wait a minute. I've got it. It's Nairobi?
No, you're right.
Am I?
Right. Slowly. Not too fast, the other way. Put your foot on the brake. Valencia. Okay now, put your foot on the clutch. Put it in first. In second, first. First, okay. Okay, now, accelerate. Take your foot off the clutch, accelerate. Good. Okay, to the left.
Gabi. Fernando, where did you get that frogs are mammals?
What do you mean, where did I get it? Didn't you know that?
Yes,
they have four legs like all the mammals.
And what are you then?
What kind of animal are you?
Well, I'm a four-wheeler, can't you see? Die!
You said.
Well,
don't worry about it. It won't be easy for him either. What's right? What's important is the exam, not Fernando.
I think we better start, Mrs. Brimmer. It is almost 10.
I'm going to call Fernando. I'll be right back.
There's no answer, Gabby. It must be traffic. All right, let's start. No. No. Whatever happened with Fernando, we're dealing with that later. You are starting alone. You are going nowhere, Gabriela. If you leave this classroom, it's all over. This is not a game. Either you do the test now, or you can stay behind with the others. And if you don't see that clearly, I do. Anytime, gentlemen.
I think it would be better if you wait outside. Please.
Come on.
First subject, conjugate these four verbs. Personal pronoun, you understand?
isn't home now. He had to have some analysis done. He got very sick, and I'm afraid it's his nerves. Some things affect him too much. It's his nerves. Some things affect him too much.
You affect him too much.
Where is he? Leave him alone, Gabby. Fight your own battle, but don't drag along someone who isn't as strong as you are. What are you doing here?
They won't let me go, Gabby. I swear I was going to.
That's not true, and you know it. He didn't want to go, and he's right.
It was you. You stopped me. You kept telling me that I would never be able to do it. That's too late. That Dad'll be furious. That you'll just suffer seeing me there. And that Gabby's a brat and a bad influence.
Fernando, calm down. You can do it. For the exam is easy. Gabby did it in 2 hours.
I can't do anything. Gabby, why don't we get married? And then I can do it. I can do it all, but alone. It's impossible. I can't do it alone. I can't. Gabby, I can't. No, enough. Leave me alone. Everyone, leave me alone.
Get out. Get her out. Fernando.
Stop, Fernando.
No! No!
It's all right.
It's all right. Well, tell her to go. Tell her to leave.
Quiet, please. I said quiet! Alonso Roberto.
Present.
Álvarez Juan.
Present.
Becerra Margarita.
Present.
Benítez Teresa.
Here.
Bremer Gabriela. Bremer Gabriela.
Present.
Cuarón Alfonso.
Present.
I don't think it was cool. So what do you know? You're a beast. Do you think that after all the work with Jimmy, I'm gonna believe in love and all that crap? I'm just warning you. God. Well, hi, Gabriela. How's it going? I want YOU to make me. Hey, she wants us to make her up. It's okay, isn't it?
Come on, we're gonna make you into a knockout.
Center, and as the years went by, Gabby became very lonely. As much as she tried to make friends, the normal children just ignored her. But Gabby continued studying hard and became one of the best students in high school.
So it becomes evident that the world around us is experienced as a series of instructions, which as they're communicated to us, function in a manner not dissimilar to the program of a computer. Norbert Wiener has described the world as billions of messages that are available to whomever takes interest in assimilating them. Any questions?
A computer program is designed to be utilized by a machine. But the world's information is interpreted subjectively by each one of us.
That's not a level in which we're interested, Ms. Brimmer.
Why not?
Why not? Please illustrate your arguments with examples.
You are an example, my dear professor.
Why did you make me say those things to the teacher?
Hello, Gabriela. My name is Luis. Listen, you were great with that pedantic ass. You're not used to people thinking around here. Can I help you?
No, thank you. It's easier alone.
Maybe another time we can get together. I'd really like to talk to you, Gabriela.
Hello, Gabby. Florencia. Gabby, I was hoping we could do that paper on Marshall McLuhan together.
What do you think? Where's the board she had?
bring it today.
Well, how is she supposed to talk?
It's just that I forgot. Didn't you learn anything with Fernando? Now you're getting into something much worse. You can't stop it. What do you want to do? Make the same mistake twice. Gabi, what's the matter? Nani? Florencia controls me. She won't let me live. Nani, what's the matter? She is jealous of people who get close to me. Nani, please stay here. You know, we have a problem with Florencia. I mean, she has no one outside of this house. She doesn't have a friend. She doesn't have a boyfriend. Nobody that I know of. She doesn't even visit her own family. And I can understand that the problems are starting now with Gab in the university.
So what do you want, Gab? You want Mom to take you to classes?
Michelle, Gabi is growing. And Florencia cannot keep up with her.
Yes, sir.
Florencia, I have something to tell you. This family no longer needs you.
Michelle, what are you doing?
Florencia. Is it true that you can no longer keep up with Gabby's classes? Why are you still here? Why do you stay with the family all these years? Why do you take my daughter to the university? You bathe her, you feed her, you dress her every single day of the year. Why? Is it because you have no one? Is that why?
No, sir. The people who are friendly to Gabi just do it out of curiosity. And then they leave. It's always been that way ever since junior high school.
And what did you expect them to do? To approach her out of divine inspiration? David, you get Florencia a chair, and you set a place for her to eat.
No, thank you, sir. I'm not hungry.
Please, Florencia, for me, just this once. Please. No, Florencia. I don't want you to feed Gabby. Please, sit down. Shari, why don't you feed Gabby?
Can you get beyond your brilliant theatrical garbage and start thinking of other people's feelings? That's the third one.
Old cars need additives.
Your heart needs a rest.
Too many miles of bad roads, Shadi.
Claude! Hello, Gabriela.
Hello, Florencia.
Hello.
I have something for you. I'd like to talk. Class doesn't start for 15 minutes. Let me see your glasses. Good invention, huh?
נחלתו וינוח על משכבו ושלום ונאמר אמן.
גדל.
יתגדל ויתקדש שמי רבה.
בעולמה?
בעולמה דיברה חירוסי.
וימליך?
וימליך, מלכוסי. וחייכון וביומכון.
Thank you.
Gabi must go to the university tomorrow.
Tomorrow is Sunday, Mommy.
He really loved you, you know. What do we do now? What do we do now, Nanny?
Mommy was never the same after Mr. Bremer died. Her spirit seemed broken. Not long afterwards, she got sick and went to San Francisco for medical treatment. David finished his studies and went to Israel to live. Suddenly, Gabi and I were alone in the house.
Hello? Can I speak with Luis? This is Gabi Bremer.
So, what's happening, Gabi?
I need a job.
You need a job? What kind of a job?
Not
as
a
Bolshevik.
Bolshoi.
Bolshoi?
Ballerina.
Not as a Bolshoi ballerina?
Darling.
Darling.
Strange, but it's interesting. Comes close to being corny, but somehow halfway through it takes off. It really grabs you. Pretty profound stuff. How old is this guy anyway?
Not a guy.
It's a girl. I should have known. He's in the university. Nice.
Should be here any minute. Can you tell me what you think?
Well, if we give her the spot, you'll have to have a change of style. Get my meaning? Come in.
It's Gabriela Bremer, sir.
Send her in.
This is Gabriela Bremer and her companion, Florencio Morales. Gabi, this is Hector Buye-Goyri, head of the cultural section.
Gabi, look! They're going to publish the article. Just a few changes. The whole editorial staff was knocked out. I don't know who you are.
where you came from. Luis is saying they're all going to lose their jobs if they're not careful.
She says, when do you ride the next one?
What the hell are you doing here? Jesus. I thought it was the milkman. What's going on? Where's Florencia? How'd you get here? All right, come on in.
Come on in.
What's this? The next article? Gabby, when did you write this? You arrived like an unexpected storm when my soul was empty. It was empty of love, of desires. When I want to run, I crawl. When I want to scream, I can barely make a sound. Is that all you're worried about? Christ, Gabby. Sometimes I want to write a novel, and I can't even get out a paragraph. I think I'm going to strike it rich. Turns out I can't even afford to put gas in my car. My feelings are so strong that I want you. Be able to talk, Gabby. You know, sometimes I get the feeling you're laughing at all of us. That you're gonna get out of your wheelchair and say, see you later, suckers, and walk away? Wouldn't be bad, would it? I can't say yes, Gabby. I can't tell you I'm gonna even think about it. Shit. You know what Florencia told me? It didn't matter what I did, as long as I didn't disappear. Well, what am I supposed to do? Make love to you? Get you pregnant?
Forgive me, Gabby. I didn't mean to hurt you. Let's go find Florencia.
Florencia. Flor.
Gabriela Bremer.
Family?
Her father is dead. Her mother is away, out of Mexico.
Who are you?
I take care of her. She has cerebral palsy. She can only move her left foot.
You're very lucky. There are deep wounds, but they didn't reach the tendon.
When can she eat?
When she wakes up.
Florencia Morales, call to San Francisco in cabin number 3. Florencia Morales, call to San Francisco in cabin number 3.
Hello? Hello? Who is this? Hey. What? I can't hear. Wait a minute.
Thank you.
That's enough.
I did it. It's for you. She made me spin. Almost all the money you left us. Where is she?
Thank you, Coppola. Thank you. Gabi continued studying at the university for a while longer, and in 1979 she had a book published about her life. It was a big success in our country, and Gabi even went on television. 3 years later, Mommy died. The doctors said it was cancer. Thank you.
Gabby and I continued living in the family house. We adopted a newborn baby girl, and Gabby named her Alma Florencia. I take care of her upbringing, and Gabby sees to her education. Gabby is writing two new books, and it makes her laugh to see Almita crawling around the room. To most people, we must seem like a strange family, but that doesn't matter. The house is full of life.